I am fighting a war against Modi.
And you had fought against Indira Gandhi also, and yeah, I was in emergency.
I was detained by in Punjab police. There's something inside burning me that I don't want Hindu Rashtra. I want a diverse country, a federal country, a country which fulfills the needs of majority of the people. We have to defeat Modi and Hindutva agenda and RSS. So that is a huge task. You have to gather all the forces. Even who is ready to walk for 1 mile, you have to take him along with.
ಪಂಜಾಬ್ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಪಟಿಯಾಲ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದ ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟತೆಯೇ ಬೇರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿನ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಧರ್ಮವೀರ್ ಗಾಂಧಿ 2014ರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಮ್ ಆದ್ಮಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಯಿಂದ ಸ್ಪರ್ಧಿಸಿ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾಗಿದ್ದರು. 2019ರಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಅವರೆದುರು ನಿಂತು ಗೆದ್ದಿದ್ದ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ನ ಮಹಾರಾಣಿ ಪ್ರಣೀತ್ ಕೌರ ಅವರು ಈಗ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿ. 2014ರ ಚುನಾವಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರ ಚುನಾವಣಾ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಲವೀರ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಈಗ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಸಚಿವರು ಮತ್ತು ಧರ್ಮವೀರ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರ ಎದುರು ಆಮ್ ಆದ್ಮಿ ಪಕ್ಷದ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಧರ್ಮವೀರ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರು ಮೂಲತಃ ಎಡಚಳುವಳಿಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರು. ರೈತರು ಹಾಗೂ ವಿವಿಧ ಶೋಷಿತ ಸಮುದಾಯಗಳ ನಡುವೆ ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿರುವವರು. ಹೃದಯ ರೋಗ ತಜ್ಞರಾದ ಅವರು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಜನಪ್ರಿಯ ವೈದ್ಯರು ಕೂಡ ಹೌದು. ಈ ಹಿಂದೆ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಸದಸ್ಯರಾಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಪಟಿಯಾಲ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯ ಹಳ್ಳಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರ ಮುಂದೆ ಅವರು ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಷರತ್ತು. ಅದೇನೆಂದರೆ ತನ್ನ ಅನುದಾನವನ್ನು ಬಿಡುಗಡೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಜಾತಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಮಶಾನ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ಆ ರೀತಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರ ಪ್ರೇರಣೆಯಿಂದ ಜಾತಿವಾರು ಸ್ಮಶಾನಗಳನ್ನು ತೆಗೆದ ಸಾವಿರಾರು ಹಳ್ಳಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹಳ್ಳಿಗಳ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಮೂಲಭೂತ ಸೌಕರ್ಯಗಳು ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟ ಅನುದಾನ. ಇಂತಹ ಹಲವಾರು ದಂತಕಥೆಗಳುಳ್ಳ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಧರ್ಮವೀರ ಗಾಂಧಿಯವರನ್ನ ಏದಿನ.com ಚುನಾವಣಾ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂದರ್ಶಿಸಿದ.
ಧರ್ಮವೀರ್ ಗಾಂಧಿಜಿ, ಶುಕ್ರಿಯಾ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಗ್ರೀಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಪಟಿಯಾಲಾ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂನ್ಸಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ a left activist who had joined Aam Aadmi Party and was MP from there now is a Congress candidate.
Yeah.
And the previous Congress MP here is BJP candidate.
Yeah, no doubt.
And your election agent, who was election agent in 2014,
yeah,
is your opposite candidate.
Yeah, definitely.
So, what is this journey? Does this also show the mahol of this country, the way it is heading up to? Because people who have fought Congress all through their life,
yeah,
thousands or lakhs of them have joined Congress this time.
Rightly,
or are supporting.
Yeah, you are right. You are right. Because India is passing through a critical juncture. This juncture is the danger of fascism. So all the democratic, secular and liberal forces, they have to join hands to defeat fascism, emerging fascism, and to save democracy, secularism, pluralism and ethos of the constitution. So left and working class forces are very weak, they are marginalized all over, including parliamentary left and including radical left. They are not able enough to take on to the existing political establishment at the center, that is BJP, and backed by RSS. So we have to defeat Modi and Hindutva agenda and RSS. So that is a huge task. You have to gather all the forces. Even who is ready to walk for 1 mile, you have to take him along with. So Congress is quite left of the center now. Rahul Gandhi is anti-corporate stand, is anti-RSS stand, anti-Abani Rani stand, and is pro-democracy, pro-pluralism, pro-federal structure stand. So is sufficient enough basis, gives me sufficient basis to join Congress in this critical juncture. It is historical, these are historical times, and one has to be seen on the right side of history, right? I mean correct side of history, not right in the right and left sense,
yes.
In right in the correct side of history, and that correct side today in a practical scenario is Congress party only.
Yeah, apart from other things, you specially mentioned federalism.
Yeah.
Because I've seen your report card also, and I've heard you in 2019 where you spoke about Punjab, Punjabi and Punjabiyat.
Definitely.
So you think that space will continue for you in Congress
also,
because
definitely.
You had started Punjab Manch, and probably you contested in name of now Punjabi party also.
Yeah.
So do you think that Congress party under Rahul Gandhi Kargeji's leadership will have space for this federal?
You see,
value?
You have to give space to Indian nationalism vis-a-vis Hindu nationalism. If you have to fight Hindu nationalism, you have to give concession to Indian nationalism. So I believe that Congress party once left of the center and Rahul himself in 2022 in Lok Sabha budget session clearly stated that India is a union of states. It is not your empire. It challenged Modi. Don't think as yourself as a ruler of the country. It is a union of states as designed or as accepted by the constitution. India is a diverse country. There are multiple entities, religious entities, racial entities, linguistic entities. There are national entities, sub-national entities, and there are cultural entities. It is a land of diversities. So one has to respect the diversity. You cannot make a unitary India like Modi thinks, one India, one nation, one tax, one election and all that. Or everything in Ekatmak Bharat, Ekatmak, unitary India. I am not for that at all. And Congress is also not for that. Because Congress in its election manifesto on federalism, it clearly states that it will give back certain issues, departments to the from the concurrent list to the state list. Earlier the trend was from concurrent list to the union list. Now Congress says we will refer back some of the what you can call departments or some of the education, health and all that.
Yeah, on the contrary, BJP had passed many laws which were actually in the state list.
Yeah.
And one of them actually the agriculture and marketing thing also.
Of course. Against which the peasants fought, farmers fought quite for a long time in Delhi, outskirts of Delhi. So,
what is the impact of that farmers' movement on Punjab? Because it was basically, though they represented the whole of farmers in the country, but it was basically led by Punjabi farmers.
Great background, leftist background. So, all the trade union movements, right from CPI, CPIM to various ML factions, they have their basis in the party. They have
you,
the strong
you,
sir, basis in the party.
You yourself was one time
strong
left activist.
Certainly, I was. There was some Gandhi who in 1971 was influenced by Marxist philosophy, which still remains. And that's why I'm in Congress. That's why I'm not sitting at home. I'm fighting a war against Modi.
And you had fought against Indira Gandhi also?
Yeah,
and I was
in emergency. I was detained in Punjab police. And when I was in final year MBBS course, so I came out of jail after 2 months, completed my studies, got into government service, did my post-graduation, then I worked among migratory workers, then I jumped into Aam Aadmi Party without going into much details of it. I thought it is a new kind of thing in Indian politics and it is going to, it promises like intra-party democracy, end of high command culture, end of VIP culture, Swaraj and all that. I was just drawn into it and something inside was burning me continuously. That took me to jail in 1975. That took me to migratory workers in Ludhiana industrial town to work for 3 years, living among them, sleeping them, eating with them and teaching them politics. Then that got me into Aam Aadmi Party. And finally, when I saw within 6 months, it is not the party of my dreams, my ideals. It is a totally right-wing party like BJP. I left the party, did politics on Punjab issue like Punjab water language and all that. Then after having interacted with Congress and with the changing Congress, the rebirth of Congress under Rahul Gandhi, which is quite left of the center. At this critical juncture, I know not only Dr. Gandhi, but every leftist organization, maybe the parliamentary left and radical left should support Congress to fight fascism in the country. Otherwise, as it happened in Germany, had communists compromised with the Democrats, social Democrats, there was no place for Hitler. So that's why I am with Congress today.
So you call Congress party under Rahul Gandhi as a social democrat party right now?
No, the many things are yet to be clarified, but at the moment it is the only force, it is the only party which is seen fighting ideological fight against RSS and BJP. Because I believe that after Nehru, with due regard for Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Ji, Rahul is the second ideological leader Congress has given birth to. He is the only second ideological leader in Congress. So I salute his wisdom and his politics. And I don't have a big, huge inning in politics. I am 73 already. Why I am, to see me how hard I am working in the area, and you have seen how hot it is. there's something inside burning me that I don't want Hindutva, I don't want Hindu Rashtra, I want a diverse country, a federal country, a country which fulfills the needs of majority of the people. There is no place for religious or religious hatred or caste hatred or caste chauvinism, religious chauvinism or capitalism the way it is practicing today, the crony capitalism. So that's why I'm here with Congress.
Dr. Gandhi, you mentioned your long journey in various sectors working with people. So that is why it looks like in Patiala, it is your campaign is also around you. We see your photos everywhere.
Yeah.
Unlike in other places where the party takes the primary role or guarantees take primary role, or it is the national leadership or state leadership.
Yeah.
But it looks like that Dr. Dharmavir Gandhi is the central figure in this election in Patiala.
You see, that always matters. The candidate's acceptability, his popularity, or his image in the people.
And even in 2019, being an independent candidate,
I gathered about 1.62 lakh votes as independent candidates. So I have my own image, my own practice, my own medicine, how I practice my medicine in public interest and but low income groups. So that makes me quite acceptable to the people of Punjab and especially the poor and the people who are marginalized.
So during campaign also you treat patients?
No, I don't treat patients, but many patients meet me in every village because I tend to nearly 150 patients every day for the last many 30 years.
In your clinic in Patiala?
Yeah.
Now who is looking after the clinic?
The other doctor, he's working with me. I've hired another doctor.
While you were a MP, Member of Parliament, even then were you practicing?
Yeah, I was practicing because politics is not my profession, it is my passion. So, doctor is my profession. Many people, while doing politics, they earn through other means. I don't earn through other means. I earn through my hard work and practice, medical practice. Parliament runs for four and a half months in a year. For 8 months, you are at your own place. You have to work in the area. So, while I work in the area, I do attend to my patients also. It is my job. I have patients from 3 generations with me, 4 generations sometimes. So I was doctor at age of 25, but I am 73. So you can imagine that for 50 years, I have lakhs and lakhs of people. So are my patients. So I cannot leave the profession.
Dr. Gandhi, while you are Member of Parliament, you also try to introduce a private bill, NDPC.
Yes, NDPS amendment.
So that is about the drug menace in Punjab.
Yeah, definitely.
But what do you think that the situation right now in Punjab?
It is very terrible. It is terrible. The drug menace is increasing with every passing day. There is a strong drug mafia consisting of politicians, police, high police officials, and some quick rich persons. So Punjab is in a mess. It is two or three young people are dying every day in Punjab and even more sometimes. There were initially, Punjab had traditional substances, recreational substances like opium and opium husk, which was non-lethal, not killing people. But once the NDPS came into existence, NDPS Act came into existence, they described these poppy husk and opium addicts as criminals. So 24,000 people are in jails because of that draconian law. They are not criminals, they are patients, they are sick. They have to be treated either with some dose of opium in a decreasing manner or with some employment, irrigation, evening managements in the villages and all that. You have to take to other media rather than oppression and make it law and order issue. It's not law and order issue. They are addicts, they are sick people. As America has changed, 42 countries have changed their laws. But India is not changing it.
So this is as an activist, a doctor and a sort of sociologist, you want to address the drug menace in this way, not considering it as a crime.
Not at all. It's not a crime. Well, alcohol is much more harmful, than opium and opium husk. But it is sold in the government shops. Government itself does business on it, collects tax on it. And why opium and opium husk? It is non-killing, but you have traditional recreational substance. Why not to have regular controlled supply of it to the people who use it?
Is it an election issue in this election also?
It is in my area, it is an election issue. People want opium husk to be liberalized.
Dr. Gandhi, we spoke about Patiala and Punjab, but what do you think the results of this election will be on June 4th?
No, I believe that BJP should be around 2,200 and 222, and it will not be able to manage the 2,273 mark. But with the money power and the manipulation it has in its hands, and with the money power and Mani Rani is at the back, you don't know which MP will be bought from which side. I mean, bought with money only, yeah, or lured into BJP. So that's one point. Secondly, if there is the increase in number of votes after release the data after 11 days by election commission, that makes it quite doubtful.
But do you think that there is resistance against Modi regime and whatever policies that BJP is
definitely
about, Punjab, all over India?
Punjab has no ground for BJP. Punjab is a different state, and Modi knows it very well.
I'm speaking about beyond Punjab, in other states.
It is there. The Hindi belt or the so-called cow belt, except that Bengal, Maharashtra, Odisha, and even Andhra Pradesh, and even other states, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. So they have no basis to exist there.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Gandhi. We'll speak to you after June 4th also. Hopefully, you will be in parliament.
I hope so. Thank you.
ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟು ವಿಶೇಷ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಲು ಮತ್ತು ಹೊಸ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಯಲು ಈ ದಿನ .com ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಚಾನೆಲ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತು ಬೆಲ್ ಐಕಾನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ.